black jelly bean. Nobody likes that.
Mike Lowry and Marcus Burnett are back for their fourth installment in the Bad Boys franchise with the highly entertaining Bad Boys Ride or Die. All right, Brad. So we are back. You know how much I love this franchise now.
I do. It scares me a little.
And as long as I was waiting for that third movie, 16 years for the third movie.
Yeah.
Not as quite as long for the fourth movie.
Before you even say any more,
okay.
What was your reaction to the third film? Because there was such a huge wait between two and three. And Bad Boys 1 and 2, for as long as I've known you, those are like heart films. They're what? They're in your top five favorite movies of all time, right?
You could argue that.
Be honest.
You can argue that.
Be honest with our audience.
Yeah. I mean, I love Bad Boys 1
and
2.
So how did you react to 3 first?
I enjoyed 3. I do think that it was... Now, you got to realize that these caveats
are coming.
I know. These characters are older, so, you know, you have to kind of factor that in as well, which I thought the movie did really well in factoring that in. I thought they did do a great... telling a great story with Mike Lowry and revealing that he has a son. So, it's like... We didn't have Michael Bay come back. And I think that these directors, Adil and Bilal, who I'm a big fan of and I like a lot, did a really good job of kind of taking that style and aesthetic that Michael Bay had in those first two films and bringing it to the Bad Boys franchise, especially with an older cast.
Yeah, and pushing the visuals too. Like the third film did push the visuals in a way that Michael Bay pushes the visuals, but not necessarily in the same way, right? So like the spirit of cinematography and advancement is in Part 3.
Yes.
And definitely in Part 4.
Yeah, visually you see these guys really take a step forward as directors visually with the camera.
So you liked 3. Did you love 3?
No, I wouldn't say I loved it, but I liked it a lot. I mean, I think, and going to Ride or Die, I want to say one of the issues I had with For Life, but Bad Boys for Life, you know, it's dealing with, and not saying that I don't like to deal with some heavy stuff, but it feels almost like a downer of a movie, a bit depressing when you're dealing with Mike Lowry getting shot and all these different things that he has to recover
all
from.
Right. So now we're in Ride or Die, and it opens with Martin Lawrence having a heart attack.
I know, but it also feels like the tone of it, they're having a lot more fun with it. Like this movie, and this is not a criticism of it, it's more of an observation. This movie at times is really silly, and it really falls in the hands of Martin, and Martin is in rare form in this movie.
He's so good.
And he is really, really good in this movie.
Yeah.
But I like the silliness of it.
But what I like, and this was present in, I would say, all 3 of the Bad Boys films. I like 3, didn't love it. What I like about Bad Boys Ride or Die is the comedy is also in the shot choice, right? And the camera movement.
Yeah.
You see it in the trailer, but when Martin Lawrence is like trying to get that hot dog on the sly and he's like looking over the spinning roasters of the dog, like the way that the camera enhances the joke.
Yeah.
It's good. And throughout the entire movie, the camera is acting with the characters.
With the characters, and that's what I like about it too. We come to these movies because we want to see the chemistry between Martin Lawrence and Will Smith, and their chemistry is undeniable. But I think since Bad Boys for Life, and now especially with this movie, it's not just Martin and Will. Adil and Bilal are bringing a lot to this movie
as well. And
they've
grown so much since Bad Boys for Life, you know, with Ms. Marvel, with shooting Batgirl and losing Batgirl.
Yeah.
And I feel like with this film, Ride or Die, it's them coming out going like, oh, we can shoot the heck out of a movie.
Exactly.
And you missed out on Batgirl.
Exactly.
I'm going to show you what we can do.
And I root for those guys because I rooted for them before that, and I love what they did with the episodes they directed with Ms. Marvel, and then when they got attached to Batgirl, that we all know the situation that happened with Batgirl. I'm glad that they were able to kind of redeem themselves and show what they can do visually and as storytellers with this movie because they really do a really good job.
And what this film does, what this script does is what the Fast and the Furious movies they acknowledge the age of these characters.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah.
Mike Lowry, you're over 50 years old.
Yes.
You say like you had a lot of growing up to do.
Yeah.
You had plenty of time to do it. Thank God you're finally there.
Yeah.
And usually I'm really not a fan of giving characters panic attacks in movies.
Yeah.
I actually think the combination of Martin Lawrence being rejuvenated after this near-death experience with his heart attack, and then Mike Lowry, Will Smith, getting the panic attacks, and he's now married, he has stakes in a way that he's never had stakes before, I thought, switching them in that way was very emotional.
No, it was. It was. And I like that as well, too, because, you know, I've heard some people make the thing like, oh, well, you know, you've seen them in the other three movies and Mike Lowrey is just like gun-toting happy and killing people all over the place. But you're right. It's like when there's stakes involved and especially like what happens, especially with, and I love how they bring Captain Howard's story into this movie and how that affects
Supernatural. Yeah, and how that affects Mike Lowrey. In this film.
Yeah, but how that affects Mike Lowrey going into his panic attacks. I thought all of that stuff worked really well for his character.
Yeah, and then also delivering some of the best action that I've seen all year long.
Nice, yeah.
There is a sequence that is that sells a joke that began in Bad Boys 2 with the character of Reggie.
Oh, right? Wow,
Like, I don't want to spoil any of it, but it involves an action scene. And that action scene is perfection.
Yes.
And the reaction of Will Smith and Martin Lawrence to that action scene
is
just heightens everything.
All I can say is the Reggie scene is worth the price of admission. Yeah. And the button that we get with Reggie
at the end of this movie.
Dude, it calls back to,
right
to part
down
two.
The barrel.
It calls back to part two, and it gives Reggie an arc. For his care, I had so much fun watching this.
Yeah, yeah, and it enhances Martin's arc too.
Yes,
it's so funny. I like Will Smith. I go like, oh, Will Smith plays Mike Lowrey. I can never remember the name of Martin Lawrence's character.
Oh yeah, Marcus Burnett.
Marcus Burnett, because he's just so Martin to me. Like I think both of those characters reach an ending, if this is the final Bad Boys film, that is absolutely satisfying in a way that 3 wasn't. So I'm so glad we got Ride or Die.
Yeah, what's your rating for this?
Oh man, I loved it. I loved it. Of course I'm giving it a B+.
Yeah, this is easily a B+. Some of the most fun I've had, and this is a crowd-pleasing movie. I saw it with a full-packed crowd, and they were reacting to all the bits that you want to react to. So yeah, this is a high B+ for both of us.
If you liked what you just saw,
then check us out on YouTube at PGC TV Online, and we'll see you at the movies.